The question for our consideration is this. Are America's progressive leaders insane? You know, a few years ago, the progressives were noticing the sharp rise in crime. Individual assaults, break-ins, carjackings, attacks on the elderly and on women. All of that was increasing at an alarming rate. Even the police were under attack as gangs broke windows on police cars. People installed security systems, armed themselves, and were afraid to leave their homes. Progressives in government came to the conclusion that the police were to blame. The police were allegedly abusive, especially in minority communities. It was obvious, the progressives thought, we need to defund the police. Well, they tried it, and what happened is now history. It was a disaster. Some city officials found that they were in danger, and some even became victims of crime. They called emergency 911. No one answered. They called and called. No answer. What's going on? Police departments were defunded. Many officers quit. They are not going to work for free. Those who thought defunding the police would lower crime were out of touch with reality. The same thing is happening today. Instead of putting a stop to illegal immigrants coming into America by the thousands, some of whom are on a terror watch list and pose a definite danger to the citizens of the United States, Secretary of Homeland Security Alejandro Mayorkas is prioritizing pronouns. Yes, you heard it right. He's concerned about pronouns. As you can see on the screen, Secretary Mayorkas is warning Border Patrol agents not to misgender illegal immigrants. Now, I'm trying to respect the laws of civility and respectability, but is this man nuts? Is he out of touch with reality? What's going on in his brain? Border Patrol agents are supposed to respectfully say to an illegal immigrant, I would like to be respectful. What name and pronoun would you like me to use when addressing you? Can you please confirm your gender identity? Close quotes. Border Patrol agents are being told, before they use certain pronouns, they better make sure they're using preferred pronouns. What are the pronouns that might be offensive? He, him, she, and her. Border Patrol agents ought to be especially careful with words like Mr., Mrs., Miss, Sir, and Ma'am. Friends, we have a major crisis on our southern border. And our leaders are doing nothing about it other than bringing up pronouns. Is there something terribly wrong with this picture? Are these people out of their minds? Now listen, even the organizer of the 7,000-person caravan that is making its way north is surprised at how out of touch this government is.
Just pushing them in, all the way to the Mexican border.
Where's the American intelligence? Don't they know that all the countries are conspiring against the United States to make sure they have this crisis?
He said this. President Biden should have seen it coming, the caravan organizer said. He has not been paying attention to what is happening. Where is American intelligence? Don't they know what's going on? Close quotes. Now, let's be realistic. These immigrants face many problems, but using the right pronouns is not one of their problems. Mr. Mayorkas is being insulting and trivializing their real needs. That's a shame. The Pentagon has also been involved in pronoun mandates. The Pentagon has had pronoun guidelines for award citations. Military awardees were to use the word themselves for joint award citations and to avoid gender pronouns. However, the Department of Defense has added a clarifying comment that the themselves can now be replaced with himself or herself when appropriate.
Hello, brave soldier of People Liberation Army. As you know, our worst enemy is the United States of America. Traditional warfare techniques are not effective against their formidable forces. Luckily, we have found their weakness. Misgendering! Our beautiful friend President Joseph Robinette Biden was nice enough to loan us some American soldier for this demonstration. Let's take a watch!
Hello there, Anyang Haseo, as your people say.
First technique is to shout wrong pronoun at American troop. Watch this. He him! He him! You are he him! You are he him! I can see clearly! You are bearded man! He him!
The Pentagon's gender-neutral pronoun requirement was first highlighted by the Heritage Foundation when the foundation revealed that Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, General Mark Milley's end-of-tour award was returned due to the use of gender-specific pronouns in a citation. However, the Pentagon's alteration was not received well, especially by GOP lawmakers. In a letter to the Pentagon, Senator Tom Cotton voiced his disbelief over the change, writing that he, quote, would welcome a replay, that this whole episode was just a practical joke or a decision you immediately reversed when it came to your attention, close quotes. Senator Cotton told Fox News that the Pentagon's directive to only use non-gendered pronouns for joint award citations was no mistake. He said, the administration has been trying to wokeify the military since Joe Biden took office. They got caught this time and reversed course. But the Department of Defense should never have adopted this absurd left-wing terminology in the first place, close quotes. So to get back to my original question, are America's progressive leaders insane? Are they out of their minds? Dr. Lyle Rossiter, MD, is a practicing psychiatrist. Dr. Rossiter has written an excellent and provocative book titled The Liberal Mind, The Psychological Causes of Political Madness. He argues that modern progressivism is a form of mental illness characterized by the failure of such individuals to grow up emotionally and thus remain in a perpetual infantile state. Whether or not insanity is the correct word for America's progressive leaders, I will let the viewer decide. One thing, though, is for sure, they are destroying the country, your country, and my country. In the words of Psalm 85, wilt thou be angry with us forever? Wilt thou draw out thine anger to all generations? Wilt thou not revive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee? That's my question. That's my desire. We need revival. We need the Holy Spirit to come in glory and power and reveal God's power to us, that once again we will have sanity in the United States of America.